Hi guys, welcome to this speed build video in The Sims 4. My name is Irene and today I am building my dragon's grave. This is a dragon or a half decaying dragon's corpse built inside the mountain. You can see one of the wings of the dragon, his claw, the dragon's head and his neck. And in front of the dragon will be a shrine. And of course, in the game there are no particular items to create dragons like this, like bones or items for wings. So in this video you can see how you can use different items in the game in so many different ways. So for example, I used a lot of towels, a lot of outdoor lights for this dragon, and of course so much more. And I cannot wait to share it with you guys, because of course a dragon, I never did a dragon before, and this video is also a part of a massive collab. More than 50 simmers joined together from all over the world. This collab is organized by Sati. Thank you so much for inviting me. And the brief for this collab was to build something where your Sims can celebrate Halloween. Because if you're watching this video on the day when I upload this, tomorrow is October 31st, 2020, Halloween. And yeah, we all wanted to do a Halloween build. I will put the playlist from this collab in the description box down below, so you can check out all the other videos from all the other simmers that joined as well. But yes, I started thinking what I could do. I got invited for that collab weeks ago. I started thinking what I could do as a Halloween build for Halloween theme. And of course, my initial thoughts went to a haunted house or something, or a very scary house, gothic style. But secretly, I wanted to do something Dark Souls themed. I don't know if you know that game franchise, Dark Souls. It's from Software, they have Bloodborne too. They're extremely difficult Japanese hardcore RPGs. Very gory, very interesting lore, very dark, and a lot of amazingly difficult but amazingly epic bosses in the game. And there are massive dragons. That's how I came up with this one. And one of my other favorite games in the entire world was Skyrim, one of the Elder Scrolls games. And I wanted to blend my three favorite games in the world, Sims, Skyrim and Dark Souls. They're so different, but I wanted to combine them all together in this build. Secretly, I wanted to do something like that. But I didn't know if it was possible to create a dragon in the game, so I started thinking about other things. But then I uploaded my last video to YouTube, my Steampunk Express, and in that build I used the toolmat a couple of times, and I was always a little bit hesitant about using the toolmat because I wanted to stay within the parameters of the game. But I love to be very creative and I love to experiment a lot in the game as well. So during that previous video I asked you guys if you mind if I used the tool mods a little bit more in the game. And thank you so much for answering that question. Every single one of you that answered that question didn't mind it at all. So I was so happy, and I thought, well, let's just give it a try. Let's just try if I could build a dragon in the game. Let's utilize the tool mod. Let's see how far I can take it in the game. So yeah, you can see the end result today, and I'm a little bit scared to share it with you, because it was a little bit of a scary build to do. Because when I started it, at the very beginning of the video, you could see I started with these curved roofs, kind of the vertebrae, is that a correct term, of the neck of the dragon. And that was the only thing that I had in my mind when I started building this. That was the only thing that I knew that I could create very easily in the game. But after that, it was an entire trial and error process. And at the beginning, I didn't knew if I would succeed in the end. So in that way, it was a scary building process, so that's kind of fitting for Halloween as well. Yeah, but it was scary, but not negative scary. It was very exciting too, and yeah, I love the experiment, so it was a very fun process as well. But yeah, let's go into how I created this entire thing. Like I said, I started with these round curved roofs, these vertebrae on the neck, and then I made that head in front of it. And when I started building on these roofs on the neck, I didn't even realize yet that we had that item that I used for the head, for the dragon's head. It's actually, yes, like a statue or something like that from the head of a Tyrannosaurus Rex. You can find it in your decorations menu when you build a bike catalog, of course, almost at the very end. And of course, I used the tool mod to rotate it, and I sized it up a lot of times. I think 10 of 12 or 12 times or something. Originally, it's a very small item. And there are a couple of items in the game that you can size up very, very big and they still look good. But there are a lot of items in the game that you cannot size up that well because they always look kind of chunky. So I was very happy to see that I could use this item for the head of the dragon. After that, I started working on these horns, and I used standing lights for them. They came with that luxury party stuff pack. And of course, I turned them, I used the tool mod on them as well. Yeah, I used the tool mod on almost every single item in this entire build, but you can see that later on, of course. And after that, I used a rock that came, yeah, kind of a spire-shaped rock that came with the Star Wars Journey to Batuu pack. And I used that as accents on the head as well. Same for another kind of curved rock. That rock came with the Get Together pack. But now I've started on the wings. Or the wing, because I made one wing. I went kind of the easy route. It's so strange to say, because this build, of course, wasn't easy at all. But I decided to build this dragon like a dead dragon, a decaying dragon's corpse, because I could be kind of rough with it. Of course, I wanted to make it perfect and detailed, but because it's a dead dragon and dragons in general are not that smooth and that precise, and I thought if I made a decaying corpse inside a mountain ice mountain, if you will, I didn't have to build the entire thing. So yeah, as far as you could call it the easy route, I went kind of the easy road over there. But when I started on the wing, yeah, first I wanted to make it with roofs. I wanted to combine roofs together because, of course, I love using these roofs, and I know you can build or you can make a lot of shapes with roofs in the game, but they were a little bit too smooth, a little bit too straight. So I started scrolling through all the items in the entire, literally the entire game, all the debug items as well, and I found these outdoor lights. They came with the Realm of Magic pack, and I thought they kind of could go as bones, and especially because they had this color, almost a similar color as the rocks and the lights and all the accents that I used on the head and on the neck. And I knew I could kind of combine them together and rotate them with the tool mod, and I could combine them with different rocks, and in that way I could make them look like bones. So these are outdoor lights that came with the Realm of Magic pack. To make these lights look more like bones, I used rocks, like I said, and these rocks came with the Realm of Magic pack as well. This was a huge time-consuming process because, of course, it was a massive trial and error process as well. I tried so many different things with different angles, but yeah, I loved it. And I said it during my previous video as well. While I was creating the train for the previous video, I had so much fun as well. And over here too. And now I only want to build things in the game that don't exist in the game yet, but that I made from different items. I'm kind of addicted on it now. I hope you guys don't mind. While I'm creating this wing, I wanted to tell you a little bit about the world that I've chosen. I'm using a 64x64 lot. Of course, I needed a massive lot for this build, for this dragon. Dragons are huge, and of course, I needed the biggest lot in the perfect world. I could use even bigger lots, but we don't have bigger lots in the game right now. And because it's a dead dragon, the wing was kind of folded together, so in that way, I could fit it on this 64x64 lot. It is in Brindle Bay, the world that came with cats and dogs, is one of my favorite lots. I made that previous build, the train over here as well, but I did so many builds on this lot before. And I especially like this one because it's kind of a blank canvas. You have this massive ground over here. You have that ocean at the back. So if you want to build something and you want to make it pop off your screen without a distracting background or something, this is an amazing lot to go for. I wanted to make that blend between Skyrim and Dark Souls. Skyrim, Elder Scrolls game, amazing as well. And in Skyrim, of course, there are a lot of dragons too. And it's in a winter world. And I thought, because I wanted to go for this darker color scheme on the dragon, I thought it would pop a little bit more if I went for a winter season. So that's why I'm building this during winter. It's the beginning of winter. There isn't a very thick layer of snow yet. I waited in game in live mode for the thick layer of snow as well, and it just all looked way too bright. So that's why I went for the beginning of winter. Now I'm adding some finishing touches on the neck here and there, and now I'm starting on the towels in the wings. At first I wanted to make just that skeleton, just with the bones of the wings, but I thought it kind of looks a little bit strange. I wanted to go for this skin between the bones of the wings as well. And my initial idea was to use curtains for it. There are very cool kind of decaying curtains with that spooky pack. But then I had to cover up so many excess curtains because I only wanted to use one part, and yeah, I tried it, it didn't work out, so I didn't know what to do then. So yet again I went through all the items in the entire game, and then I came across this bathroom accent. It's kind of a towel, but you cannot find it when you go to just the room section in your build and buy menu. Just when you click on bathroom accents, you cannot find it. It's just amongst the normal, I think, wall decorations. It came with the Spade pack, and it comes in a lot of different colors, and it's a little bit see-through, and I thought it was a perfect item to create that skin between the bones of the wings. Of course, I sized them up again. I used the tool mods again. I rotated them in different angles. Not only, I think three different angles. And in that way, I made that skin between the bones. And like I already said, because it's a decaying dragon, I didn't mind that it didn't look extremely smooth or perfect. You know, because a dead or decaying dragon isn't smooth or perfect as well. So that's the items, these are the items that I used for the wings. These lanterns, these outdoor lights that came with the Realm of Magic pack, and these towels and the rocks that came with the Realm of Magic pack. Now I wanted to add a little bit more of detail on the neck and a small part of the body. So I used some arches. They're debug arches, so they're a hidden item. Normally you can place arches on walls, for example, but when you free place them without using a wall and when you turn the screen around, they can glitch out a little bit because normally they're supposed to be inside a wall. But there are arches, these black arches that came with the Realm of Magic pack. No, that's not correct. With the Vampires pack as well. And you can use them without seeing that glitch. Now I'm creating the mountain at the back. Of course, I already placed a couple of rocks in to cover up that very thick plate that was underneath that statue that I used for the dragon's head. And I went for the same color of rocks. These rocks, they came with the Get to Work pack. And I used these particular rocks because they're kind of white. Even without the snow on them, they're already a little bit white. And I thought in that way, I could make the entire dragon pop off your screen a little bit more. Of course, it's a little bit strange because this build is horror themed and I'm talking about dragons, corpses and things like that, and it's very sunny and bright out here. I could go for a cloudy weather or for night, for example, but in that way I always, when I'm building during these parts of the day, I think you cannot see that good what I'm doing on your screen because it's way darker. You cannot see the items that good and how I'm placing everything in. So that's why I made a decision to build it during the day and to make the outro and the intro and the whole cinematic thing during the day as well, because I thought it showed the dragon a little bit better. But this dragon, I wanted to say build, it's a build as well. This build looks very cool during the night as well, because all these lights that I used on the wings and as accents as the spikes on the head and the horns and everything, of course they light up during the night. The entire dragon is finished right now and I wanted to do something in front of it as well. I had that space left. I didn't want to make a house out of this, or I didn't want to make rooms inside it. I didn't have that much space as well. And the entire challenge for me during this build was to see if I could make a dragon shape or a dragon's corpse in the game. But of course, I still wanted to make it worthwhile to pull off the gallery and to visit this a lot with your sim if you want. So I will make a shrine in the front of this dragon above the water. Now I'm placing in some swords here and there, and later on I will place in some shields and some skulls as well. This is completely inspired by Dark Souls. When you go to an extremely difficult boss in Dark Souls, a very big boss, you can always see swords and shields and skulls from previous warriors that dared to fight these bosses. So that's why I wanted to do something like that as well. Like this dragon was slain during an epic battle with massive swords and shields and skulls. Yeah, I know, I'm such a nerd, but I love it so much. And yeah, I wanted to place in some tombstones as well. They came with the vampires back, some more rocks here and there. Now I'm starting on the shrine over the water. The water looks very white right now. I will change up the color in a couple of minutes. And sometimes I get the question how I make my water look realistic in the game. Well, really, it really depends on what kind of color you use on the ground and on the walls in the pool, because that's how you make water in the game, of course, with pools. When you use a dirt color on the ground or on the wall, it will totally change up the look. And you can see that in a couple of seconds, I hope. Here's a walkway to the shrine over here. And I placed in some rocks here and there. Over here I wanted to place in this statue. This looks very Skyrim-like, very Elder Scrolls-like. You have in Skyrim the shrines of Azura, like this Daedra. I don't know if I pronounced it correctly, but they're kind of dark spirits or gods. You can get several quests over there, and there are always these beautiful statues of beautiful women with an altar in front of them, and I a place in that altar in a couple of minutes, of course. I wanted to give that altar a little bit more, so I placed in some of these dead trees. They came with the vampire's pack as well. For the altar, you can see over here, I used a bench or an ottoman. This one came with the Realm of Magic pack. This book, this magic book that I use. I really thought about Skyrim when you're walking through that game and when you approaching a shrine like this. What can you see lying on the shrine? And normally you can find a chest there and a magic book or something and some gems and a chandelier. So I really ducked in my mind. I don't know if that's the correct term, but I really thought about that. What I could see in a game like Skyrim or something like that. You can see the chest over there and, like I said, a chandelier here and there. But yeah, then we're almost on the end of this video. In the end, of course, you can see an outro. Not really a tour, of course, but I made some cinematic shots from the entire dragon. I'm so curious what you thought about this build. Please let me know. I'm so happy that I can freely use the tool mod now in the game. It opens up a world of possibilities. And I truly believe that you can build everything you want in the game if you experiment a lot with different items and normally used for different things. And if you use that tool mod, I really think it opens up, like I said, a world of possibilities. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, you're in that outro already, please do. I try to do so many different things with my builds, so if you want to keep yourself inspired for your own builds, please consider to subscribe. I will be back next Tuesday with my brand new video. I really hope to talk to you then. Have an amazing day, and right after this, when I uploaded this, the live stream for the new pack Snowy Escape will be online. I'm definitely going to watch that. Please let me know if you watched it and what you think about the new pack. Well, I'm rounding up now. Have an amazing day. Talk to you next Tuesday. Goodbye.